Friends, we are continuing this torsion chapter, shafts. We are continuing that. I have selected a few more problems. In the previous video, we have done one problem. We will do a few more problems in this. I have selected problem number 7 next. Last time I had selected problem number 5. Now the problem is like this. A solid circular shaft is required to transmit 100 kilowatt, so P is 100 kilowatt, at 180 rpm, N is 180 rpm. The permissible shear stress in the shaft, Fs, is 60 newton per mm square. Find the suitable dia of the shaft if the angle of twist is not to exceed 1 degree. If the angle of twist is not to exceed 1 degree in a length of 3 meters, take the value of rigidity modulus as 0.8 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per mm square. This problem is slightly different from the problem which we did, the fifth problem that we did there. Here, again, they have given the power, they have given the speed. So, if these two are given, we can get the torque. Same way as we got it in the previous problem. Again, we will get the torque here, mean torque. Now, here, he doesn't say that the maximum torque exceeds the mean torque by so many percentage or something like that. So in that case, what you do is the torque that you get by from these two data is the maximum torque. We are not going to increase it because they have not told it. Then they have given Fs, theta, L and C. That means we have to find the diameter. We have to find the diameter by both strength basis as well as rigidity basis in this problem, and then we have to adopt. So first thing is we have to find torque. So torque or twisting moment will be P into 60 divided by 2 pi n as we did previous problem. So P is 100 into 60 divided by 2 into pi into 180. So let us find it out. 100 into 60 divided by 2 divided by pi divided by 180. That will give me 5.3 kilonewton meter. I get it in kilonewton meter, or it is 5.3 into 10 to the power of 6 newton millimeter. This is the torque. Now, this itself is the maximum torque. We are not going to find the maximum torque because he hasn't said it. Now, what we have to do is design or finding dia by strength basis. So what I will do here, I will use this part. T by J is equal to Fs by R. So T is that 5.3 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by J is pi d to the power of 4 by 32 is equal to Fs is 60 divided by d by 2. That by 2 can be placed here. So 1d here again cancels, pi d cube. So pi d cube cross multiplying into 60 into 2 is equal to 5.3 into 10 to the power of 6 into 32. You get this by cross multiplying. So d cube will be equal to d cube will be equal to d cube will be equal to 5.3 into 10 to the power of 6 into 32 divided by pi into 60 into 2. So I have got that into 10 to the power of 6 into 32 divided by pi divided by 60 divided by 2 equals, I get 450316 point something. Now I want the cube root of that. D will be the cube root of that. So cube root of answer will give me 76.65 mm. Something like this I got. Now we will not adopt it. We will not adopt it now. What we do is, we will design by rigidity basis also. Rigidity basis. Now this will be, theta will be 1 into pi by 180. To convert degree into radian, you know, you have to multiply by pi by 180. So pi by 180 will be equal to 1 into pi by 180 will be equal to 0.017 something, 174 radians. This is so many radians. So now the equation is, the equation to be used here is T by J is equal to C theta by L. This is the equation. So 5.3 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by pi D to the power of 4 by 32. By 32 is equal to C 0.8 into 10 to the power of 5 into theta 0.0174 divided by C theta by L. L is 3000 mm. It is given as 3 meters. So in mm it will be 3000 mm. Now we'll cross multiply. If we cross multiply, we get pi d to the power of 4 into 0.8 into 10 to the power of 5 into 0.0174 is equal to 5.3 into 10 to the power of 6 into 32 into 3000. This into that. So d to the power of 4, I want d. So d will be equal to, send all this that side, 5.3 into 10 to the power of 6 into 32 into 3000 divided by pi into 0.8 into 10 to the power of 5 into 0.0174, fourth root of this, or whole to the power of 1 by 4. Whole to the power of 1 by 4 it will be. This will be equal to d to the power of 4, so d will be equal to that whole to the power of 1 by 4. So now we will take up this here, 5.3 into 10 to the power of 6 into 32 into 0.0174, sorry, into 3000 divided by pi divided by 0.8 divided by 10 to the power of 5 divided by 0.0174 will give me something 116347 something. I want the fourth root of this. To get fourth root, what you have to do is, this answer is there. I have found this answer. It is something like this. This is equal to 116347.75, something like that. I have to find the fourth root of this. To find the fourth root of this, what I will do is press 4, shift, power, answer. This will give me the fourth root. It is 103.85 mm. This is the answer I got by taking the fourth root. This can be done. If it is fourth root, it can be done this way also. Square root of answer equals, again square root of answer equals, that way also it can be done. You will get the same answer. Or see, 1 by 4 is 0.25. If you divide 1 by 4, you will get 0.25. You can put power, directly power 0.25. Then also you will get the same answer. You can do it any way you want. Any way you want, you can do it. So we have got D as 103.85 mm from rigidity basis. We had earlier got it as, on when we did it on strength basis, we had got it as 76 point something. Now of the two, this is the bigger answer. So we will write, therefore adopt D as this is also not a standard value. So the next standard higher value is 110 mm. So you will adopt 110 mm as the diameter of the shaft. So this finishes this problem. I once again request you to share, like, comment and subscribe this channel so that we can give you good videos. I will move on to the next problem. I have selected problem number 13. We did 5, 7, again now I am taking up 15, problem number 15. Sorry, 13. Problem number 13 I have selected. A hollow shaft is required to transmit 300 kilowatt. This is the power at 90 rpm. This is speed, 90 rpm. The permissible shear stress in the shaft is 60 newton per mm square. The maximum torque transmitted exceeds, that is T max, is 25% more than the mean torque. Internal dia is half of external dia, or it can be written as 0.5 times DO. Find the external dia of the shaft, find the diameters of the shaft. So we have to find out outer and inner diameters of the shaft. This is what we have to find out from this given data. Again, here, first we have to find out the torque. The procedure to find the torque is the same, whether it is solid shaft or hollow shaft, it doesn't matter. The procedure to find the torque is the same. That is, P is given, N is given. So we will find out torque by this. This is the mean torque, 60 P divided by 2 pi N. Because P is equal to 2 pi N T by 60, I get this. 60 into P is 300 divided by 2 into pi into 90. So I get, what do I get? Let us see what we get. The procedure remains the same, 60 into 300 60 into 300 divided by 2 divided by pi divided by 90 is the RPM. So it is 31.83 kilo Newton meters, or T is 31.83 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton millimeter. Now they have given T max here, so we have to find out T max. T max, that is 25% greater, means it will be 1.25 into T. So 1.25 into 31.83 into 10 to the power of 6. Don't multiply this 10 to the power of 6, just multiply these two. I have got that 31 point something here, multiplied by 1.25 will give me 39.8 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton millimeter. This is the maximum torque. For this torque, we have to find the diameters. Now here, it is a hollow shaft. The earlier, both the problems that we did, it was a solid, both were solid shafts. Now it is hollow shaft. But the formula, the equation, torsion equation remains the same. So what I will do is T by J, only this formula I have to use, is equal to Fs by R. They have not given C, theta, L and all that is not given. So I have to only use this formula. Now this will be T by pi DO to the power of 4 into 1 minus k to the power of 4. This is a hollow shaft, divided by 32. That 32 will come here. Fs divided by DO by 2. That 2 will come here. Now 1 DO cancels with 1 DO here. We are left with DO cube. Now this T means it is T max. It is understood whenever they have given maximum torque, this is T max only that we will take. So this is cross multiplying pi DO cube into 1 minus k to the power of 4 into Fs into 2 is equal to T max into 32. Now we want DO cube, so T max I have got, I'll note it down here, 39.8 into 10 to the power of 6. So DO cube will be equal to T max into 32 divided by pi into 1 minus k to the power of 4 into Fs into 2. This is extra here. This is all that is extra. Otherwise, it is the same. So DO will be 1/3 of this. So DO will be equal to, now I will make a substitution. T max, that is 39.8 into 10 to the power of 6 into 32. Divided by pi into 1 minus, this k is di by do, that will be 0.5. K is di by dO. That is, dO is half of that, means di is 0.5 dO divided by dO. dO gets cancelled, it is 0.5. 0.5 to the power of 4 into Fs is 60 into 2 whole to the power of 1 by 3 or cube root of that. So I'll make calculation here. First, what you do this: 1 minus 0.5 to the power of 4 equals, this is 0.9375. What I will do is into pi into 60 into 2. I have multiplied these things and I have kept that answer as it is. Now I will do the numerator: 39.8 into 10 to the power of 6. 10 to the power of 6 into 32. This I did, divided by answer. Why I did like this is because there is minus here, so I did this first and then do it. I got 3603550 something. I want the cube root of this. Cube root of answer is equal to 153 point something. dO is equal to 153.3 mm. Adopt, I will take it as 160 mm. This is dO. So di will be 0.5 dO, that is 0.5 into 160, that will be 80 mm. This is the inner diameter and that is the outer diameter. This is how it is to be done. This is the problem, 13th problem. We will do one more problem. I have selected the 15th problem from the question bank. The question problem goes like this: a solid circular shaft is required to transmit. I am taking the 15th problem. It is a combination of both solid and hollow shaft. 15th problem. A solid circular shaft is required to transmit 40 kilowatt. So P is 40 kilowatt at a speed of 400 rpm. Shear stress, ultimate shear stress. The ultimate shear stress is 360 Newton per mm square, and factor of safety is 8. Take factor of safety as 8. Maximum torque, it is given. T max is 15% more than, that means 1.15 times T. If a hollow shaft, this is over, so find the diameter of the shaft. This is one part. The second part is, if a hollow shaft is to be replaced in place of this solid shaft, find the internal and external diameters. Find di by dO. Find di and dO if it is a hollow shaft. Second stage. This is, if the ratio of if inner dia is half the external diameter, that means K is 0.5. What is di by dO if K is 0.5 instead of this? All other things remaining the same. So that is the 15th problem. I have selected that. I'll take this problem now. Now again, the first thing that we have to find out is the maximum torque. We cannot find the dia of the shaft without knowing the torque. So first thing that we have to get is the torque, and the procedure to get the torque is the same. T is equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi n. Same procedure. So P is 40 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 400. So that will fetch me 40 into 60 divided by 2 divided by pi divided by 400. That will give me 0.95 kilonewton meter, or it is 0.95 × 10⁶ newton millimeter. Now T max, maximum torque, is 15% more than mean torque. So 1.15 × 0.95 × 10⁶, that gives me will give me 1.1, approximately 1.1 × 10⁶ newton millimeter. So I got the maximum torque. Now Fs, permissible shear stress, will be ultimate shear stress divided by factor of safety. Next, that is 360 divided by 8, that works out to 45 newton per mm square. This is the allowable stress. This is one twist they have done, one twist which is done in this problem. Now next, T max only by strength, by J is equal to Fs by R. This is the formula. So T max is for solid shaft. I am designing a solid shaft. It is T max is 1.1 × 10⁶. 1.1 × 10⁶ divided by pi d to the power of 4 by 32 is equal to 45 divided by d by 2. I am designing the solid shaft. 1d gets cancelled. So you get d cube is equal to 1.1 × 10⁶ × 32 divided by pi into 45 into 2. So d will be cube root of that, 1.something × 10⁶ divided by into 32 divided by pi divided by 45 divided by 2 will give me 124287 something. I get the cube root of that. Shift cube root of answer will give me 49.9. So I am getting D is equal to 49.9 mm. So say or adopt 50 mm. This is if it is a solid shaft. Next, if it is a hollow shaft, same power, same RPM. So torque remains the same, maximum torque remains the same. Now same material, so Fs remains the same. We have to find out what is hollow shaft. If it is a hollow shaft, what is DO and DI we have to find out. So DO, the formula remains the same. DO cube will be equal to T max into 32 divided by here pi into 1 minus k to the power of 4. This is what is extra into 2. This will be the same formula. So 1.1 × 10⁶ × 32 divided by pi into 1 minus, this is 0.5 to the power of 4 into 45 into 2. So cube root of that will give me the answer. So 1.1 × 10⁶ into 32 divided by pi Now we'll do one thing. We'll do like this. We'll do like this. 1 minus 0.5 to the power of 4. First we'll do this 0.9375 into pi into 45 into 2. That is the denominator I got, 265 point something. Now 1.1 into 10 to the power of 6 into 32 divided by answer will give me 132794 something. Cube root of that, cube root of answer will be 51. DO will be equal to 51.01 something it will come. Mm. We can take it as 55 mm. 55 mm. Or adopt. Adopted over. We have adopted it as 55 mm. So DI will be 0.5 into DO. That is 0.5 into 55. That works out to 27.5 millimeter. This is the inner diameter. That is the outer diameter. This is the design of hollow shaft. Now, I think we have, you have understood it. You please subscribe and like my channel. Thank you.